All the priests gathered here today in our cathedral certainly know how to celebrate Mass. Now, there may be some slight differences in style or gesture, but within the general framework of our received liturgical tradition, we all know what to do and what to say. This shared understanding of the Mass is the immensely rich heritage of the entire Catholic priesthood. For most of our lives, we have studied the theology of the Eucharist, because the Mass is simply so essential both for us and for the people we serve. But I suspect that it is something of an occupational hazard that Mass can sometimes become more of a routine than an awesome privilege. No other action of the Church equals the power and effectiveness of the Mass. Instead, we need to remember the succinct teaching of the Second Vatican Council, that the Mass is the source and summit of the entire life of the Church. It is most certainly the source of our experience of grace, because the Mass makes present the Lord's one perfect sacrifice on the cross, offering superabundant atonement for the entire weight of human sin. It is also the summit of Christian living, because we bring to the Mass our own continuing service, our commitment to continuing conversion, and our personal experience of God's great love. Remember, in the upper room and on the altar of the cross, Christ, our high priest, gave to the Father that offering than which a greater gift could never be conceived, because Jesus offered himself. He is forever the only begotten Son, God for God, light for light, true God for true God, who for our sake and for our salvation came down from heaven and became man. Through the measureless power of the Holy Spirit, and through your ministry as priests of the New Testament, his life, his death, and his resurrection are truly renewed in every Mass, as the supreme epiphany in time of God's everlasting love. Therefore, attentive participation in the Mass is something that, as priests and as people, we owe to God as a tithe on our very existence. St. Thomas Aquinas taught, worship is really a matter of justice, a debt of thanksgiving, our duty and our salvation, that we as creatures owe to the Creator, and that we as Christians owe to our Redeemer. But the Mass is ever so much more than merely a responsibility. At Mass, we can encounter the alluring mystery of the living God. And so if we are recollected and perceive with the eyes of faith, the Mass should overwhelm us, baffle us, transform us, astound and amaze us. The Mass should drive us on and set our hearts on fire and energize our ministries and all our works of mercy. In the Most Holy Eucharist, in that intimate communion with Jesus, we can cry out, Lord, draw us closer to you. Lord, live in us, so that we may always live in you. Lord, we want to belong entirely to nothing held back, just as you held nothing back. Or as the psalmist once rhapsodized, like deer thirsting for running streams, so our souls are thirsting for the living God. The oils that we bless today are essentially associated with the incomparable power present in the most holy Eucharist. The oils become outward signs of the inward reality of the Holy Spirit. Blessing the church and gathering the church into that gift of boundless grace that is freely offered in the Mass. The oil of the sick comforts and often heals those who are ill, restoring them to the Eucharistic assembly. The oil of the catechumens effectively anoints new believers, expelling the malignant influence of evil spirits, and powerfully strengthening those called to the Easter sacraments. And the most holy Chrism extravagantly sanctifies the baptized and confirmed, preparing them to receive Holy Communion, enhancing their experience of the risen Christ, and calling them to lives of discipleship. This solemnly consecrated oil anoints as well the hands of priests and the heads of bishops, empowering them, according to their order, to preach the word of God, to offer the holy sacrifice, and to build up the church, which is truly Christ's body. This lavishly perfumed oil, signifying the transforming presence of the Holy Spirit, also anoints our altars and those sacred spaces set aside for the praise and thanks and worship of the Lord of heaven and earth. We know that every Mass is holy beyond all compare, but this annual Chrism Mass is truly an extraordinary moment of grace in the life of the Church. It is in Holy Week, when we recall with fear and trembling the mighty acts of our Savior, who utterly defeated sin and death, and won for us our eternal salvation. And it is during these days of awe that Catholic priests throughout the world, and today here in the Catholic Diocese of Peoria, will also renew the solemn vows they once made at their ordination, when through the grace of God, they actually became other Christs, serving as ministers of Christ the Head for the glory of God and the service of His people. Beloved in Christ, unworthy though I am, speaking from the cathedral as your bishop, I authoritatively proclaim that what we celebrate together is simply an infinite gift. The renewed splendor of our cathedral should remind us that at every Mass, our own hearts and souls can be richly renewed. At Mass, we have already entered into the threshold of the heaven of heavens to adore the God of gods. At Mass, we can already behold countless hosts of worshiping angels surrounding us and singing with us in unrestrained exultation. The most blessed and glorious Virgin Mary, good Saint Joseph, the holy apostles, the martyrs, the holy virgins and confessors, and all those who have gone before us truly unite themselves with our intercession. Here at Mass, Jesus, our crucified and risen Savior, offers worthy praise and thanks to God his Father. Through the actually become a part of his offering, a part of what we receive, a portion of his most precious body and blood. So it would be sheer insanity that we ever allow this divine liturgy to become merely a human routine. Something taken for granted, something marginal, something sometimes even neglected. So priests and deacons, consecrated religious, the elect called to the Easter sacraments, the young and the old of this local church, all the chosen people of God during this Holy Week, in this year of our Lord, 2017, and for the rest of your lives, welcome these holy mysteries. Consciously savor this feast of faith, this celebration of hope, this school of love that we share together in the Eucharistic assembly. Enter fully. Enter today. Enter now and forever into the unsurpassable joy of union with Jesus, your Lord and your God. As in words of prayer, deeply rooted in our Catholic tradition, let us implore, soul of Christ, sanctify, body of Christ, save, blood of Christ, inebriate me, water from the side of Christ, wash me, passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within your wounds, hide me. Separated from you, let me never be. From the malignant enemy, defend me. That I may praise you in the company of your saints for all eternity.